Recently, Congress has mandated that all branches of the military review policies that restrict female members' service.
Open all their ground combat units to women by the end of this year.
Kind of mandating that we look into fields like infantry or artillery or tanks are areas that females have not.
In April 2015, 400 students began a 61-day combat leadership course known as Ranger School. It is considered one of the most elite infantry schools in the U.S. military. For the first time in history, 19 women were allowed to take the course. This is a story of one.
My name is Lisa Jaster. I'm originally from Plymouth, Wisconsin, and I'm a major in the Army Reserve. My mother has more energy than any woman who's ever walked this earth. And when we were little kids, she used to tell my brother and I all the time, don't ever say I should've, I could've, or I would've. The typical day, my alarm goes off at 4 o'clock every day. I get up, have a snack, go straight to the CrossFit box. I'm usually there around 4:30, and I open it up and start my workout. After that, I head to Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, where my husband meets me. We have a babysitter who comes and watches the kids while they're sleeping, so that he and I can do Jiu-Jitsu together in the morning, come home and start taking the kids to school. We come into the house, eat our breakfast, and each go our own ways to work.
So I'll fly on Saturday, only 5 days away. My son is six and a half, so he's excited about it, and he thinks it's wonderful, and he loves bragging about this. And then every once in a while when I tuck him into bed, he'll say something like, I'm already proud of you, Mommy, you don't have to do this. We push our kids to try everything, even the three-year-old. She's out with Daddy, shooting her bow all the time. And, you know, my son will also say, he knows why I'm doing it. He knows that to be a good mommy, to be somebody who wants her kids to reach for the stars, I've got to do it too. And he's very bright.
I'm happy because she's trying new things, and I'm scared because I don't want her getting hurt.
I think the biggest thing that affected everybody was me cutting my hair. And I came home and my son was like, Mommy, you're still beautiful on the inside. How terrible.
I look at Lisa just in awe all the time because her level of commitment and her dedication to everything that she does in life, not just Ranger School, is just something to just want to copy and duplicate. She just is very focused. I remember when she said, I want to go to Ranger School. How are you going to handle this with a full-time job at Shell? You're coaching here and you've got jiu-jitsu and your CrossFit training. And she just said, this is something that I want to do. And we never, ever once doubted that it was something that she could not do. I mean, of all the people in the world that I could think of to go to Ranger School and excel, I think Lisa Jaster can do it.
If you get on the plane and make it to Georgia, you know, you're already a winner and you've done things that most people couldn't possibly dream of. And so, you know, from here on out, you know, this, in my mind, the stress is off. She's already done awesome things for her country and for the Army in general and for women. So I'm anxious to see how it plays out. And I agree with her. If she can stay healthy, she's got a really good shot to make it.
People that I haven't stayed in touch with that have reached out to me after 15 years and said, I'm not sure how I feel about women in the infantry. I'm not sure how I feel about women at Ranger School, but I know how I feel about you. And if you make it across Victory Pond, I'll be there at your graduation. To include a very old friend sending me his Ranger tab and a very neat note. He's got a daughter and he wrote me a note saying, I thought my daughter would be the first female Ranger, but I hope it's you.
Toughest men in uniform today. That is the reputation won in battle by the men of the United States Army Rangers.
In order to understand the significance of the U.S. Army Ranger School, you have to understand what a Ranger is. Rangers take great pride in their elite history. Rangers have fought in wars from the American Revolution to the beaches of Omaha. Ranger School developed during the Korean War in order to teach soldiers how to lead through the most trying challenges of combat. Rangers know what it's like to be hungry, to be tired. They know pain. and they know sacrifice. The school is open to all ranks, open to all branches, Navy, Marine Corps, Air Force, Coast Guard, as well as allied military students. It's also open to all jobs. The guy on your left or your right can be a medic, a truck driver, or an engineer. The purpose of Ranger School is to train soldiers to be leaders. Rangers are experts in leading soldiers on difficult missions in high-stress situations. For more than 2 months, Ranger students train to exhaustion, pushing the limits of their minds and their bodies. When every aching bone tells them to quit, they keep going.
Ranger School, we refer to it often as the Army's premier leadership course. It takes men and women to some dark places. You're not eating very much, you're not sleeping very much, and it's the closest the Army can get in a safe situation to simulating combat scenarios. Each time I met with a new group of men, in my head I was saying, okay, I have the ability to prove to them that women in the military can do a little bit more. And that's kind of how I woke up every day. Ranger School is advertised as a 19 and a half hour training day. While you're in the field, some days you get 15 minutes of sleep, some days you get 30 minutes to eat and sleep. Hands down, being sleep deprived is much worse than being hungry. Let's put it this way. I was standing in cold water in the swamps, a full pack on my back, carrying a weapon, sleeping. Just standing there, sleeping. Yeah, the pack was helping me float a little bit, and when we started moving, somebody had to wake me up so I could move forward. And that's not normal. In mountains, I volunteered to carry the 240 because I thought, well, I'm gonna do it today. And we were walking through the mountains and it was hard on everyone. But it's that feeling of accomplishment. One guy said it to me one day. He's like, every hill you walk or every mountain you climb, you think you can't do it. And once you get to the top, you can't believe how easy it was. During the road march, I came in the first quarter of the guys from our company. And some guy, I never saw his face, just said to me, you killed me. I ran the whole thing because every time I looked up, you were right behind me and I couldn't let you finish before me. And said to me, I'm sorry. For everything you never heard me say, I'm sorry. And I've changed. When I recycled, I called home to tell my husband, hey, you know how I said I was coming home to you? Well, I've got 3 more weeks and then I restart. And he said to me, do you think you could possibly get through this? What do you think will be different? And I said to him, if I do nothing else here, every person I come into contact with, male or female, is changing their opinion about females in the military, about how schools are run, how we deal with each other. But people are changing.
There are 3 phases of Ranger School: Darby, Mountain, and Swamp. 60% of the students will fail in the first 4 days. For those who move on, statistically, they will still have a difficult time. 1/3 of all students will repeat a phase. It's called recycling. At least 15 students a year will recycle every single phase.
Now, when Chris and Shay moved on and I didn't, that was by far one of the hardest days of Ranger School for me. I remember Chris coming over happy, expecting me to stay. I was also moving on. She gave me the biggest hug, and I looked at her literally with tears in my eyes saying, I'm done. I can't do this.
And I was skeptical if they could handle it physically. Then we got to mountains, and there was one night we were doing a long walk. I was the 320 gunner, so I had a lot of weight on me, and I was struggling. And I stopped and I asked a halfway point, hey, can anyone help take some of this weight? I got a lot of deer in the headlight looks. You know, a lot of people were like, I can't take any more weight. Shay was the only one to volunteer to take that weight. She took the weight off me, and she carried it the last half of that ruck.
These two females have shown themselves that they can serve by my side at any time, because I know I can trust them, and I hope that they can trust me.
Ranger school is definitely a team event, and what makes recycling hard is you're starting over with a new team each time. With the guys, it was a transition for most of them. It was, I don't believe women should be here. Okay, well, I need you. Otherwise, I can't pass my patrols, and you need me to pass your patrols, so let's just work together. By the time we got to the last day of the field problem, people forgot that one of them was different than the other. People were really worried about the sleeping conditions or a woman's physical ability to lift things. I hear a lot of times the comment that my husband weighs X amount, his equipment weighs so much, no woman would be able to drag him out of a firefight. I guess what I want people to do is stop worrying about whether a woman can do it and say, well, can a 150-pound ranger do what's necessary to accomplish the mission? I think on days that I got really down, I never ever thought about quitting, but I definitely thought about wanting to go home. Mentally, the hardest thing for me was missing my family. I don't think it was that different for me than it was for the dads. I had a guy in my platoon whose wife was pregnant, and every day he would look at an ultrasound and he would just sit there and stare at it. I saw the fathers being just as heartbroken with their missed events and not seeing their children. I wanted to be the best soldier I could be.
You know, Ranger School isn't about me and my family. It's about a lot of people, and a lot of people are passionate about this and love or hate the concept of women going to Ranger School, but it's a bigger deal than just the Jaster family. It's important to try to do hard things, but it's also important to look at the big picture and see how you can add to society and maybe make the world a little bit better.